and gentlemen, this is a lightweight contest consisting of 4 3-minute rounds. Introducing to you firstly in the red corner, wearing the blue and white shorts, he weighed in at 10 stone and 1 pound, from Birmingham, David Hines. And in the blue corner, wearing the white shorts, he weighed in at 10 stone, 6 pounds and 11 ounces. From Scotland, Tony McPake. And your referee for this contest is John Keane from Northampton.
So four rounds at lightweight between unbeaten Scottish prospect Tony McPake and Birmingham guy Dave Hines. McPake in the white shorts, Hines in the blue. And Spencer, this really should be a fight that McPake should be looking to win inside the distance if he's going anywhere.
Well, McPake is the prospect. Now 5 victories from his 5 contests, 3 inside. And they will be looking to build him up. And this is the right sort of fight for him at this stage. David Hines, very experienced, 49 fights himself. Looks to survive, but it'll be a good job if McPake can do him inside the distance.
Well, he hasn't been stopped now for 6 fights, Dave Hines. He's lost them all, of course, on points. But he has been stopped 11 times during his career. And therefore, McPake, who's won 3 of his 5 victories inside the distance and carries a fair dig, should be looking to stop him, really.
McPake just trying to take the centre of the ring, pushing out that jab. Hines just covering up well. McPake not really getting through of anything at the moment.
He's a good amateur pedigree, McPake. Boxed in the Commonwealth Games at the age of only 18. And he lost in the first round, stopped by South African in 4 rounds. But that was no disgrace. And he's won 3 Scottish ABA lightweight titles. So he's no mug, this man. And Scottish boxing really is flourishing at the moment. Let's see if McPake can become another star from up north. Good jabs.
Yeah, looks to have a nice style. McPake keeps his hands up nice and high, just looking to measure him for that right hand. But taking his time, nice start from McPake, nice controlled.
It is controlled, Spencer. Sometimes these young prospects are too eager, wanting to please everybody. Good right hand from Hines, though. And he'll have been taught how to survive. He's obviously learning to do that. I said he's been stopped 11 times, but you know, he's starting to survive these days, and Norman Nobby Nobbs, the gym he comes from, has certainly taught him well in the mode. Oh, good right hand there. Shook Hines.
Yeah, solid right hand from McPake there.
Does carry a fair dig, but Hines, in all fairness, is coming back with some shots of his own. Sometimes, you know, attack is the best form of defence.
Well, Hines doing the right thing, keeping the hands up nice and tight. But McPake just looking to pick those shots. An excellent right hand there. Really took Hines down to his boots.
Hines is fighting regularly. He's boxed last month and lost in Tottenham to Dave Stewart. So he'll be fit, there's no doubt about that. But he'll need to be because he's under pressure from McPake, who's banging those body shots in, Spencer.
Yeah, stepping around the side, lovely there, and really picking those right hands to the body. Hines taking those shots well.
Good jab, he picks his shots well, McPake. Nice fading, there's not enough of that in boxing these days by young prospects. He's a good boxer. And they go back to the corners. And not too stressed by that first round, Spencer.
No, McPake done a lovely control first round there. Just took the centre of the ring, pushing out the jab. Started stepping around the sides and whacking those right hands to the body. Solid start from McPake, and one that he clearly won.
He's a good prospect at the age of 22. Good future ahead of him, and this is why.
They're really picking those shots well. Look at the way he's doubling up on that left hook, looking to step round the side. And he's just really driving that right hand through the middle. That was the one that sent the shiver right down to the boots of David Hines from another angle. Really high on the head, but a solid shot. looks to be carrying a bit of power. He has got 3 KOs out of his 5 wins. Still very young, only 22 years of age.
Yeah, he's trained well. Very good success rate there. 46% success, that's good. Professional boxing. Second round. So Tony McPake in the white shorts has been well on top during the first round. He'll be looking for the stoppage to impress the critics around these days. And Dave Hines was shaken. And again, the right hand lands from McPake.
Again, McPake just trying to pick those shots. Come straight out, took the centre of that ring. Looking to get through with that right hand again. Hines can do nothing but cover up at the moment.
He's doing the right thing, Tony McPake, Spencer. He's, you know, confusing Hines. He's throwing lots of little shots and changing the angles.
It's nice to see a fighter using that boxing brain, you know, picking different shots from different angles. Not everything just coming behind the jab. You never know what he's throwing next.
A good right hand again there on the counter. Just step back and step back in with the right hand. Forces Hines to hold on. I think he's slightly hurt Hines here, and McPake, if he caught him with a few more clean shots, would have him in big trouble.
Yeah, you feel that McPake needs to pick this up now again, getting through with a couple of solid right hands. Just feel if he picks this up, he could stop this one.
Well, it's only 4 rounds, and although he's only had a short pro career so far, 4 rounds shouldn't be any trouble to a young, fit, top-class amateur. Showing off a bit now with the left jab. Feels very confident, you can see that.
Yeah, ran a solid jab, really snapping that out in the face of David Hines. Hines needs to start moving that head, rolling out the way of those shots. He's just picking his hands up, but there's no head movement, no lateral movement at all. He needs to start moving that waist again. McPake getting through with the right hand.
Well, Hines, as I said, has been stopped 11 times, and 2 people, Kevin Lee and Jason Cook, they are top professionals, have stopped him in so 1 round. So McPake will be looking to do similar here. And this is a sign of how good a prospect is Spencer sometimes, is how they work an opponent out. Can he do something different now to stop this man?
Well, that's what he's trying to do, McPake. He's looking for those openings. You can see him working behind that jab, trying to step off the side. So he's tried a few things. Now he's boxing on the back foot. He was pushing forward. But he's trying to draw Hines in now, trying to open him up for that right hand. Hines doing well, surviving here, keeping his hands up nice and high, taking some solid shots.
Yeah, he's a good old pro, is Dave Hines. He's 31 now, and he's had 51 fights. He's lost 45 of them, but always gives people a good, decent test when he's not stopped in one, that is, I should say. Recently took Scottish prospect Willie Limmen the full 6 rounds. Great uppercut, right hand there from McPake.
And that solid uppercut.
Yeah, it was a great shot, Spencer. Forced to Hines, he's still holding.
Really drove that shot through. Should be jumping on Hines now. Stop!
Well, another round up for Tony McPake, and Dave Hines slumps back on his stool. Andy Mayer's there in the corner. Norman Nobby Nobbs leaning over the ropes. Well, there's the stats, Spencer. 24 jabs landed to Hines' 2.
Well, that tells a story. McPake really working well behind that jab. Drove in a lovely right uppercut towards the end of that round. He's picking the shots well. Some of the action in the round. There's that lovely jab driving through the guard of Hines there.
Great jab, and watch for this right uppercut. Right uppercut, no, landed a moment. It's a superb shot.
But that's what impresses me about McPake, the accuracy of the punches. We see there 46% accuracy rate in the first round, and then again there, he's really driving those shots, not wasting anything at all. Good, solid performance.
Yeah, it's a great economy of punches, you say.
Second round, round 3.
So third round, halfway through this 4-round lightweight contest. And Tony McPake doing the right thing, boxing well, using the jab, just waiting for the openings.
But this is where I'd like to see McPake now, picking it up, starting to put his foot on the gas and putting Hines under some real pressure, because you felt towards the end of that round he could, you know, if he turned it up, he would stop Hines. And that's what he needs to do. He's come out again, took the centre of that ring, ramming that jab out. He needs to follow up with that right hand and those hooks.
Yeah, he's been forced to hold a little bit himself there, left over the top from Hines. And I think he knows he needs to be careful. give Hines a bit of respect. Decent pro. But as you say, maybe now with two rounds left, he should put everything into this. Good right hand lands again.
Solid right hand. Hines took that shot well. But Pake maybe needs to work on a bit of lateral movement himself, getting that waist moving a bit. Keeps his hands nice and high again with the solid right uppercut.
And that hurt Hines. He was thrown to the floor. But make no mistake, he was hurt. The referee says no fight. Wait, he's hurt his jaw. Jaw, he's saying. I think he's broken his jaw, Spencer. I certainly hurt it.
Well, it was a solid right uppercut, right to the chin. And I feel that he may be even broken his jaw. You can see the pain on Hines' face.
Well, he certainly cricked it. Whether he can speak or not with a broken jaw, that clearly is another thing. But it was certainly a good right uppercut. He landed it in the second, and he knew he had success with it and landed it again. And whereas he forced his opponent to the canvas, and therefore the ref gave no count. Make no mistake, he was hurt by it.
Yeah, we see the warnings in the previous round, a good right uppercut just towards the end of the previous round, and then again landed it there. He was really looking for that shot there, bam.
Right on the side of the jaw, and Hines holding on, and a little shove to the canvas, but it was a decent punch.
You could see Hines grimacing there as soon as that shot landed. Picked the shot so well, McPake. Again, see it, driving the shot up. Look at the pain on Hines's face there.
Yeah, there's no doubt that hurt.
Solid, solid performance there by McPake. Looks like an excellent addition to the lightweight division.
Looks good. Okay, well, let's get the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, in 1:24 of round three, your referee has stopped the contest with David Hines in no condition to carry on. Your winner from Scotland, Tony McPake.
So a good win for McPake. Makes it 6-6. Still unbeaten and looking good for the future.
A super featherweight contest consisting of 6 3-minute rounds. Firstly, in introducing to you in the red corner, wearing the black shorts and taking part in his 25th professional contest, a former European title challenger from Poland, Dariusz Sosnowski. And in the blue corner, wearing the blue and white shorts, he weighed in at 9 stone 7 pounds. He comes into the ring with a professional record of 15 contests, winning 13, 6 inside the scheduled distance, 1 loss and 1 draw. He is a former British super featherweight challenger from Glasgow in Scotland, Craig Doherty. Your referee for this contest is Spencer Elton from Derby.
Okay, lads, give me a nice clean fight, okay? When a sharp break, do so straight away. I obey my instructions, okay? Best luck to both of you. Shake hands.
For the first round...
Talented box puncher Craig Doherty rebuilding after his brave but disastrously fraught effort to take the British title last year, outgunned really by Michael Gomez pretty rapidly. Interesting to see how he deals with the solid, strong and stubborn Polish import Dariusz Sosnowski, who has asked one or two questions before of our top 10 super featherweights. Doherty in the blue trunks from Glasgow and a pretty decent fighter.
Yeah, Doherty, after that disastrous defeat by Gomez, trying to rebuild here, but not an easy opponent in front of him in Dariusz Sznarski, an excellent amateur himself, well scored. This should be an interesting contest.
His former European title challenger, Sznarski, who's going for a bit of a bad spell now. He's lost four in a row, but he comes full of experience and the test of time. Doherty much younger and electing to stand in the middle of the ring, much like he did with Michael Gomez. Slow start here from Doherty, who needs to get the jab working. Good boxing skills he has, but with Gomez, he elected to war with the Manchester fighter, and it proved very dear.
Yeah, that really was his undoing, standing there with Gomez, trying to trade blow for blow, but Sznarski, only the one KO in his 12 wins, so Doherty feels that he's got that confidence to stand there and try and pull Sznarski back. Sznarski's best when he's coming forward. Doherty just trying to take that centre of that ring, covering up well.
Not afraid to throw the lever at all, Dariusz Sznarski. Not the biggest puncher. And Doherty might feel he can walk him down. Looks slightly bigger to me, Craig Doherty.
Yeah, Doherty is big for a super featherweight.
Weighed in at 9.7.5 to Sznarski's 9.6. But what I like about Doherty is his skills and movement, which we saw in the early part of his career. And that's better. Trebling up on the jab.
Yeah, very slow start from Doherty, but just starting to get the punches off now.
Excellent left hook to the body, and Doherty finally beginning to take some sort of control after a pretty stagnant opening 2 minutes from him.
Well,
there's the Doherty slate. 13 of his 15 to 1 defeat to Michael Gomez, and a surprising draw against the heavier Lee Armstrong of Huddersfield. His best win, I think, today was when he knocked out Jamie McKeever in 3 rounds up in Scotland, and he's got talent, and finally at the end of that one was beginning to use it.
Yeah, just started to pick that left hook under the elbows of Sznarski, looking to drive that shot in. And only started to step it up at the end. We've seen doubling up there as well with that jab. Good finish to the round from Doherty.
Second round, round two.
Here's the second round in the 9-stone-4 or 130-pound super featherweight division. Bustling with talent on the British scene like Alex Moon, Alex Arthur and Kevin Lear. Michael Gomez still in the reckoning, and the man who lost to Gomez rehabilitates here in Coventry. Craig Doherty, the 22-year-old from Glasgow in his 16th outing, meeting the 33-year-old Dariusz Sznarski from Bielstock in Poland, who's becoming quite a regular on our shores. In fact, in his last fight, had Liverpool hope Tony Mulholland down before losing on points. He's pretty fair for a test, isn't he?
Yeah, Sznarski, like I said, he was a good amateur, boxed in the Barcelona Olympics, throws his punches in clusters, and then gets away. Doherty can't be found wanting here. He needs to start getting that jab working like he is there, switching those shots underneath. He can't allow Sznarski to lead off first.
Turned professional a little too late, I think, Dariusz Sznarski at 29 after that excellent amateur career. She beat Justin Rousell, the man that shared a ring with Ricky Hatton last year. Doherty not moving around the ring as well as he might. Good right hand though.
Sznarski coming back well. Just starting to liven up now. Doherty spending too much time just stalking forward, not enough work from him. Shinarski's getting off with some good shots again, getting through with the right hand there, Shinarski.
The right hand was the punch that hit Alex Arthur once or twice in their intercontinental title fight north of the border in March. And Arthur managed to pretty much walk through Snarski, stopped him in 10 and looked impressive doing so. But does throw so many, Snarski, a few are bound to get home.
Yeah, he does like to throw in clusters of punches as we see him trying to open up there, not finding the range there. Doherty for my money, just not doing enough work at the moment.
Trying to get the jab going, which is his best punch. But now, trying to get Snarski to trade with him. And I don't think that's Doherty's best idea or really in his makeup. He's not that sort of a fighter.
He's spending too much time loading up here. Doherty needs to start getting his own combinations going. Right.
What a strange performance here from Craig Doherty, really, but learning against this Darius Snarski. Well, let's have a look at where Craig Doherty ranks in the British top 10. He's in there at 10. Alex Moon, Kevin Lear, who beat Michael Gomez in that shot recently. Alex Arthur, who many feel is the star of the division, or certainly will become so. Willie Limond to fight Arthur for the vacant British title sometime in the autumn. And Doherty, fair enough, about 10th?
Yeah, that is fair. I mean, the super featherweights at the moment are very strong. We've seen some good names there. Strong division in Britain at the moment. And on this performance, Doherty certainly wouldn't be any higher than 10. He really needs to start picking it up now.
Third round. Craig Doherty's second fight since his loss for the British title. Last time out, he knocked out Joel Viney, the Blackpool man, in a round to rebuild some confidence. Now a trickier assignment against Poland's Darius Snarski, who's shared the ring with some good fighters and was decent enough to beat Vincenzo Belcastro and Frederic Bonifay earlier in his career. Good right hand again gets through in the Snarski corner, applauding. And Doherty, to me, just looks lethargic and slow tonight.
Yeah, there's not enough work coming from Doherty. He's spending too much time waiting to counter punch. Need to start getting that head moving. Snarski's got through with a couple of right hands. Doherty just nicking the first couple of rounds on my card, but there's not a lot in these rounds. Doherty needs to start doing more. He can't afford to wait to let Snarski lead off first. He needs to get off with his own punches.
It's slightly disappointing what's happened to Craig Doherty. He's only 22, so he's got time to come back stronger. But he looks such a skillful technician as he won his first 12. But said he'd box Michael Gomez and take him into the latter stages, and all he did was stood in front of him and had a tear up. And you don't do that with Michael Gomez, or certainly not the Gomez of a year ago.
Snarski getting through some good clusters of punches there.
Get the feeling with Snarski that he's been in with so many good operators that if he finds his footing in a fight like this, he'll rather fancy it. The one he had with Tony Mulholland was fairly close, but that's better from Doherty. A body shot going in there, partially blocked, but that was the punch that undid Jamie McKeever. And let's see some more of those.
You know, it really was a good win over McKeever. He looks like a different fighter when he puts those shots together, Doherty. Right. We haven't seen enough of that yet.
So what you're saying is cut the machismo out and get back to your boxing.
He needs to get back to his boxing. He needs to start mixing those shots up like we know he can do, to the body and the head. Spending too much time loading up here.
Again, caught with a right hand coming in, Craig Doherty, but did enough to win the round for me.
Yeah.
I'm not so good rounds, you better rounds than that. It's been lazy that round, okay? You never lost a round, but you didn't look as good as you should have. I'm a bit busy, I think, okay?
Darius Snarski there. The 25th fight of his pretty short professional career, only 4 years. But as an amateur, he fought in the World Championships in Finland and in two European Championships, as well as in the Barcelona Olympics. Could have been a really good fighter.
Yeah, just lacked the power. Snarski in the pro ranks, but putting the shots together well and getting through.
Corners, 10 seconds.
The guard of Doherty. Doherty really needs to start letting those combinations go. He's allowing this one to go a bit close. I've got Doherty winning those first three rounds.
Second half then of this interesting encounter between Craig Doherty and Darius Snarski. There you have Spencer has it three rounds up to Doherty, but it's been closer than that.
Yeah, the rounds have been very close. Snarski working well with those clusters of punches. Doherty's ones look to have more effect, but not throwing enough of them at the moment.
As he's trying to bully Snarski, Doherty. And that's finer work from him with the jab, keeping the pole at bay. Trying the left hook round the side as well for the first time, Craig Doherty. He's having to put up with some blood from the nose. When he gets distance, Spencer, Craig Doherty, he really looks quite good.
Yeah, when he lets those combinations go, he does look good. Doherty just trying to stalk forward here, looking to pick it up. You feel that he's looking to let those combinations go. But Snarski is an awkward customer to fight.
Left to the body. One solitary shot from Doherty. And Snarski put seven or eight together that missed. I'm sure he's learning a fair amount in there, Craig Doherty. I'm sure they all do with Snarski.
Well, he's certainly a good learning curve in your boxing career. I mean, Snarski, excellent amateur, been around the block a few times and a very awkward customer to fight. Doherty's still only 22, so this will be a good learning contest for him.
Yes, Snarski, who's fought all around the world, and Craig Doherty has fought little outside Glasgow. Lost in seven rounds to Stefano Zoff. Darius Snarski.
Snarski getting through with a good right hand again there. Doherty carrying that left hand quite low. Getting caught again with the right hand. Needs to work on that defence, Doherty.
Yes, he's keeping his gloves high now. But once he's thrown three or four Doherty, he just lets his hand slip and leaves himself open. Nasty cut too by the right eye, but not too badly at the moment.
That doesn't look too bad, a cut. Again, very close round. Difficult one to score. Maybe just lean towards Doherty for the better work, but Snarski letting those clusters of punches going.
Snarski, who was Unlucky not to beat James Rooney in his debut over in Britain. Said he got robbed that night, but he'll have no complaints about the way Alex Arthur took care of him. But then, is Arthur the star we think he is?
I think Arthur certainly is the talent out there at the moment in the super featherweight division.
Second round, round five.
6 minutes to go of this sixth round super featherweight contest. Worldwide King Asselino Freitas and the British division starting to warm up at the moment. Craig Doherty will hope to get another shot at the British title, which is vacant at the moment after Michael Gomez gave it up and then lost to Kevin Lear. So it swings and roundabouts in this division, and solid jabs from Doherty that we haven't seen since the latter minute in the first round.
Yeah, not been boxing too well this evening, Doherty. Been very lazy, needs to start picking it up in these last couple of rounds. The first four have been tight, I've got him winning them, but they have been tight.
You often wonder how a fighter will come back from a pretty torrid defeat. We wait to see how Gary Lockett, the unbeaten light middleweight, will come back from that terrible loss in Cardiff a few weeks ago. Well, Doherty came back well in the first fight back against Joel Viney. But has that brawl with Gomez taken a bit more out of him than we thought?
Oh, Snarski, such a gritty little character, trying to push forward again with those clusters of punches. This is where Doherty now needs to come back with his own combinations.
More blood trickles down the right eye of Darius Snarski. But he's worked all night, the Polish trial horse or journeyman. You can't really call him that. He's better than that.
Well, you look down the record and the losses that he's had have been quality opposition. Been boxing at a high level for some time now, Snarski.
He also lost in Poland to Jason Cook, who's continuing his own comeback in the higher lightweight division.
Snarski doing well in this round, letting those clusters go. Doherty spending too much time on the back foot but not doing enough work.
Hey, the performance by Alex Arthur over Snarski is looking more and more impressive, and a little bit of nastiness between these two. Snarski threw a shot. Doherty looked like he was going to throw ahead but didn't. And I think there's some frustration going in as gloves go down and punches land. Fortunately, at the bell, they split. Well, what was all that about?
Well, it certainly heated up there towards the end of that round. Perhaps that's just what this contest needed. Both trading blow for blow at the end. Solid right hand going in from Snarski, and Doherty hitting with the head that was wrong from Doherty, and he was lucky not to get deducted a point there from another angle. There was a solid shot gone in. Doherty coming back with that head.
Touch of what Dominic Negus did to Audley Harrison the other night, although I think that was a little bit harder than that one.
Well, he was very fortunate to not to get away with losing a point there, Doherty.
Obviously frustrated at his own performance, Craig Doherty. It has not been exceedingly good in any stretch of the imagination. Well, they do touch gloves rather reluctantly for the final round of what's been a good contest. And it's been made by the work rate of Darius Snarski, who you give only the fifth round to.
Well, the first four rounds were very close. I had Doherty maybe just doing the better work, but they were very close rounds. Snarsky's the one here trying again, trying to force the pace. Stockett's been very lazy this evening.
I've got Doherty a couple ahead just because the cleaner work has landed from him, but it is pretty tit for tat round after round, and Craig Doherty has not got into any sort of rhythm tonight. He hasn't flowed at all.
No, it hasn't been an impressive performance by Doherty, getting through with a good left hook there and the right hand.
Yeah, that's good work from Doherty, and again, best stuff coming off the jab, but has to eat up a couple of right hands as he gets too close. What does he have to work on?
Doherty needs to start working on putting those combinations together again, just loading up with the single shots, being too lazy, not enough head movement.
If you took a tape of his fight with Jamie McKeever and this one tonight and you compared the two, what would the advice be? To go back to what he was doing before?
Certainly, you'd have to say that the performance against McKeever was top class. That's what put him up there in the rankings. That's what got him the shot for the British title. He would never get a shot on this performance. Snarsky again getting through with the right hands. What a gritty little character Snarsky is.
Absolutely, still pressing forward. And how many punches has Snarsky thrown in these six rounds? A phenomenal effort for a man really coming to teach the prospects a thing or two and go away by losing on points. Well, he probably will, but he has fought every bit of the way and he will be very welcome back. Well, for the likes of Willie LeMond or any of the other up-and-coming prospects.
Snarsky really trying, driving the shots into the body and head again.
I tell you, Spencer, if this was 8 rounds or 10 rounds, I wonder if he'd finally catch up with Doherty.
Snarsky certainly won the last couple on my card, really picked it up, and Doherty's not been out of go with him. Doherty's earlier lead may have won in this contest. Been a very frustrating night for him.
Very impressive sixth from Darius Snarsky. Spencer and I both have Doherty just winning, and he does get victory number 14. But he is pretty exhausted as he goes straight to the Snarsky corner, I think, to congratulate their man. It was a grueling affair for 18 minutes. Hats off to Darius Snarsky, and what do we say about Doherty? Good night or bad?
Well, it was certainly was a bad night from Doherty. Spent too much time, was pushing out the jab, needs to get back in the gym, work on those combinations again. Wasn't enough work there. The work that we did see, we could see was quality, but wasn't enough from it, enough of it.
Darius Snarsky earns a fifth payday against British fighters, and let's have him back, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of this contest, your referee Spencer Elson scores the contest. Snarsky, 56 points, Doherty, 59. Your winner from Glasgow in Scotland, Craig Doherty. Thank you.